An armed officer in every school. That's the demand right now from Florida's Governor Rick Scott, who today unveiled a long list of changes he wants made to Florida's gun laws. Listen.
Today, I'm calling for a mandatory law enforcement officer in every public school. These law enforcement officers must either be sworn sheriff's deputies or police officers and be present during all our students are on campus. I disagree with arming the teachers. My focus is on bringing in law enforcement. I think you need to have individuals that are trained. Banning specific weapons and punishing law-abiding citizens is not going to fix this. What we have to do is we have to really focus on the problem. We've got to take all weapons away from people with mental illness.
Another big part of the governor's proposal is banning the sale of all guns to anyone under the age of 21. Right now in Florida, you could purchase an AR-15 style rifle, for example, at the age of 18. Our Kaylee Hartung is joining us from Parkland, Florida, right now at the Stoneman Douglas High School. Kaylee, so what else is the governor calling for, and how soon does he want all of these new steps implemented?
Well, Wolf, Governor Scott wants $500 million spent on protecting schools in this state. He introduced this three-part plan to address gun laws, school safety, and mental health. This after spending a week talking with the students of Stoneman Douglas, the teachers, law enforcement, as well as leadership from state agencies and mental health experts. The bottom line is he wants to make it virtually impossible for anyone with a mental health issue or anyone who could be a threat to them or others to be unable to purchase or use a gun. Let's roll through some of these points of his action plan. As you mentioned, he doesn't want anyone under 21 to have the ability to buy a gun. He wants there to be tougher background checks and longer waiting periods. And by the start of the 2018 school year, Wolf, he wants one law enforcement officer per every 1,000 students on a campus. That means Stoneman Douglas last Wednesday would have had three law enforcement officers for their 3,300 students on campus, as opposed to the one that they did. He also wants metal detectors, steel doors, and bulletproof glass put in on campuses, and he wants more dedicated mental health counselors on hands to help students through their problems. He also mentioned a ban on bump stocks and said he may abandon tax cuts to help pay for school safety. And students among those who made the trip to Tallahassee to speak with Governor Scott earlier this week, Wolf telling me they find this plan encouraging, but right now it's just words. They continue to demand action from the Florida State Capitol. The governor has 2 weeks left in this legislative session to, as he said, work aggressively with lawmakers to make this more than words, Wolf.